So what would actually happen if you got rid of all the bacteria that's living inside your body? You have 100 trillion microbes growing outside and inside your body right now. That's 10 times the amount of your actual physical body cells. Okay, if you were to wipe out all the microbes in your colon, which is the majority, what would potentially happen? Well, let's first take a look at what these microbes actually do. 90% of all of your bile that is made from your liver, stored in your gallbladder, gets recycled by microbes. Okay, so right there you would have low amounts of bile salts, so therefore you could not absorb vitamin A, D, E, K, K1, K2. You wouldn't be able to absorb omega-3 fatty acids, the other essential fatty acids. You would have a major deficiency of certain healthy fats in your body, which have all sorts of consequences. You wouldn't be able to make the B vitamins anymore, or the vitamin K. You wouldn't be able to make this compound, okay? So the microbes actually eat the fiber from your diet and turn it into this, which helps your blood sugars, and it also feeds your colon cells. So you wouldn't be able to feed your colon cells. Your immune system would greatly suffer. The majority of your immune system is in your gut, but the microbes actually help defend against pathogens. That's why, for example, the lactic acid microbes make lactic acid to actually make an environment where these microbes can't live. You wouldn't have any lactic acid as a defense. You wouldn't be able to maintain the epithelial gap, so you would have leaky gut. So you'd have a lot of allergies and immune problems and food intolerances. You wouldn't have this immune defense mucus layer. You would have a neurotransmitter deficiency because these microbes actually make proteins, especially serotonin. 90% of your serotonin is made by these microbes in your gut. So if you got rid of 90% of your serotonin, you wouldn't be a very happy camper. You wouldn't be able to counter infection. You would be filled with inflammation. You would have blood sugar issues. You wouldn't be able to absorb nutrients like vitamins and minerals and proteins. And lastly, you would lose your ability to detoxify. But other than that, you'd be perfectly healthy. I'm being very sarcastic. Now, I have other videos talking about how we lose our friendly bacteria, but I want to touch on antibiotics for a second, because all it takes is 1 week of exposure to an antibiotic to affect the diversity of microbes and the quantity of microbes for 6 months to 2 years. Also, if a mother doesn't breastfeed, that child is a lot more susceptible to allergies and asthma. Same thing goes with C-section delivery versus a natural vaginal birth. But the big point of this video I'm going to talk about is this right here. 80% of antibiotics are not sold for human consumption, but they're sold to companies that use the antibiotics as a growth factor for animals, okay? So for example, if you go to the store and buy commercial steak, chicken, pork, and it's not organic, chances are it's exposed to antibiotics. So now I have some good news and some bad news. What do you want to hear first? The good news? Okay. Well, thank goodness, in 2017, the FDA came out with a rule stating that antibiotics can no longer be used for growth or feed efficiency unless supervised by a veterinarian. That's exciting. Now we can actually finally get rid of the antibiotics and get our bodies back to health, right? Well, the bad news is that there's no definition of antibiotic-free, and there's been no reduction in the antibiotics given to these animals after this rule was passed in 2017. Why? Because there's this thing called a loophole that they're using, okay? Because it says no longer can be used for growth or feed efficiency. So what they're using now is they're not using it for growth. At least they're not saying they're using it for growth. They're using it to prevent disease, disease prevention. So just by changing the intent, they continue to use the antibiotics. What the FDA should have said is that antibiotics should no longer be used, period, okay? But unfortunately, that's not what happened. So here's what I recommend. When you buy your animal products, farmers markets, okay, health food store, organic. at least with an organic certification, they're not supposed to be using antibiotics or pesticides. All right, guys, thanks for watching. So if you want to get notified with all my content, click the notification bell next to subscribed.